Question number 161. Which of the following is not an example of infrastructure as a service? Option A, virtual network. Option B, Azure SQL database. Option C, virtual machine. Option D, SQL server in a VM. Option E, virtual machine skill sets. The correct answer is option B, Azure SQL database. Infrastructure as a service, IaaS, provides fundamental cloud resources like virtual machines, networking, and storage, giving users full control over their software and configurations. Virtual machines, virtual networks, and virtual machine skill sets all fall under IaaS because they require user management. However, Azure SQL Database is not IaaS. It is a platform as a service, PaaS, because Microsoft fully manages its maintenance, security, and scaling, making it the exemption in this list. Question number 162. What would be a good reason to have multiple Azure subscriptions? Option A, there is one person or credit card paying for resources, but many people who have accounts in Azure, and you need to separate out resources between clients so that there is absolutely no chance of resources being exposed between them. Option B, there is one person or credit card paying for resources, and only one person who logs into Azure to manage the resources, but you want to be able to know which resources are used for which client project. The correct answer is option A. There is one person or credit card paying for resources, but many people who have accounts in Azure, and you need to separate out resources between clients so that there is absolutely no chance of resources being exposed between them. Having multiple Azure subscriptions is ideal when you need to completely isolate resources between different clients to ensure there is no accidental exposure of resources. Subscriptions provide a hard boundary for security, compliance, and billing, making them useful for multi-client environments where strict isolation is required. Question number 163. Which of the following is a good example of a hybrid cloud? Option A, technology that allows you to grow living tissue on top of an exoskeleton, making terminators impossible to spot among humans. Option B, your code is a mobile app that runs on iOS and Android phones, but it uses a database in the cloud. Option C, a server runs in your own environment, but places files in the cloud so that it can extend the amount of storage it has access to. Option D, your users are inside your corporate network, but your applications and data are in the cloud. The correct answer is option C. A server runs in your own environment, but places files in the cloud so that it can extend the amount of storage it has access to. A hybrid cloud is a combination of on-premises infrastructure and cloud resources. In this case, a server in your local environment uses cloud storage to extend its storage capacity, which is a good example of a hybrid cloud. Question number 164. Why is a user ID and password sometimes not enough to prove someone is who they say they are. Option A, user ID and password can be used by anyone, such as a coworker, ex-employee, or hacker halfway around the world. Option B, password must be encrypted before being stored. Option C, passwords are usually easy to forget. Option D, some people might choose the same user ID and password. The correct answer is option A. User ID and password can be used by anyone, such as a coworker, ex-employee, or hacker halfway around the world. A user ID and password can be easily compromised if someone gains unauthorized access, such as a coworker, ex-employee, or a hacker. This is why additional forms of authentication, like two-factor authentication, 2FA, are often required to verify a user's identity. Question number 165. What is the Azure SLA for two or more virtual machines in an availability state? Option A, 99.90%. Option B, 99.99%. Option C, 100%. Option D, 99.95%. The correct answer is option B, 99.99%. Azure provides an SLA of 99.99% for two or more virtual machines deployed in an availability state. This ensures high availability and redundancy by distributing the VMs across multiple physical servers to reduce the risk of downtime. Just a quick reminder, if you don't want to watch all these videos and instead download all questions and answers, then feel free to purchase them on Buy Me a Coffee page. I have shared the link below. Question number 166. Which tool within Azure is comprised of Azure Status, Service Health, and Resource Health? Option A, Azure Advisor. Option B, Azure Dashboard. Option C, Azure Service Health. Option D, Azure Monitor. The correct answer is option C, Azure Service Health. Azure Service Health provides insight into the health of Azure services, including Azure Status, Service Health, and Resource Health. These tools help monitor and troubleshoot the status of Azure services and resources to ensure minimal downtime. Question number 167. How do you get access to services in private preview mode? Option A, you must apply to use them. Option B, they are available in the marketplace. You simply use them. Option C, you must agree to a terms of use first. Option D, you cannot use private preview services. The correct answer is option A, you must apply to use them. Services in private preview mode are typically not available to the public. To gain access, you must apply, often through an invitation or request process, and may need to be selected or approved by Azure. Question number 168. Which of the following cloud computing model requires the highest level of involvement in maintaining the operating system and file system by the customer. Option A, PaaS. Option B, FaaS. Option C, SaaS. Option D, IaaS. The correct answer is option D, IaaS. In the IaaS, Infrastructure as a Service model, the customer is responsible for managing and maintaining the operating system, file system, and other infrastructure elements. The cloud provider manages the hardware, but the customer has more control and responsibility over the OS and software layers compared to other models. Question number 169. What is the new data privacy and information protection regulation that took effect across Europe in May 2018? Option A, PCI DSS. Option B, FedRAMP. Option C, ISO 9001:2015. Option D, GDPR. The correct answer is option D, GDPR. The General Data Protection Regulation, GDPR, took effect across Europe in May 2018. It aims to protect the privacy and personal data of EU citizens and imposes strict guidelines on how businesses handle and process personal information. Question number 170. What is the service level agreement for two or more Azure virtual machines that have been manually placed into different availability zones in the same region? Option A, 100%. Option B, 99.95%. Option C, 99.99%. Option D, 99.90%. The correct answer is option B, 99.95%. For two or more Azure virtual machines placed in different availability zones within the same region, Azure offers an SLA of 99.95%. This provides higher availability by distributing VMs across multiple zones within a region to minimize the risks of downtime.